Yes. Now we'll start with a new unit. Just I'll share the things. Yes, share. Yeah, welcome. Now we are coming to a third unit, that is an M2M and IoT technology fundamentals. According to your syllabus here, we have discussed in a last unit two about a mass market perspective of an M2M technology towards IoT, that we have discussed how a market prescriptive will be there, starting from a global value chain and M2M value chain and IoT value chain and structure technologies needed for an IoT. Then how a market monopolist will be there. That and all we have discussed, and later on we have gone with the architecture basics that we have discussed. Once the market, everything we have analyzed, then we have gone for how we can design the IoT projects. For that, we need an architecture to design any of the types of a project. So what we have made, we have gone with a reference architecture where it will be like an abstract. We will take the things, means it will not solve the particular problem, or the architecture will not be made for a particular problem or objective. Overall, it will be there. From that, we will go for an applied architecture. So what applied architecture is, we'll bring in components, say that different components we'll take from a reference architecture, and we'll place that to solve a particular problem or to achieve a particular objective or a goal. Using of that means designing of that particular architecture is the applied architecture, as we have seen. And like that, we can next develop the project according to that, and we'll arrive to our solution or goals. And we have seen the pyramid of an IoT project also, from how a sharp problem domain we are going for and knowledge frameworks there. So that also you have discussed. And the in depth after that, we have gone with the different things. I mean, so how the IoT outline architecture will be there, means in depth. And we have discussed each and every layer and what are the three cross layers is there for each and every layer is needed. We have discussed that. Once we are ready now with the architecture, and we know that what are the layers is needed in IoT project, and all, everything is ready with us. Now, what in this particular unit we are going to do? That's the question arises. In this particular unit, we are having a lighting down what are the fundamental technologies which we are going to use fundamentally, not in depth, as I have told, according to the syllabus. So what are the fundamental technologies now which we need? Now I have architecture, and I have told it, design it, so sensor I need, and so node I need, everything I have decided. Yes, now I need a technology. What's the technology here? How are the different technologies I am going to use in this particular thing? For example, if I want to make the bulb switch and on through my mobile, so what are the different technologies I need here? So in entire this particular chapter, we are going to study how the technology will help you in a different ways, and what are the different technologies will be there here, and how you are passing through all the technologies. So entire unit will be discussed on that particular issues. Coming to the goal of this particular unit or a lecture. The lecture intends to provide an overview of technology fundamentals or building blocks that form the basics of M2M and IoT. So that I told you that we'll see an overview how technology fundamentals will work, and how these technology terms, sensors, actuators, or any network devices or any service oriented devices which we are using. So all these things, how it will become a building blocks for an M2M or an IoT project. So this is the goal of this particular lecture. Now outline, what are the things we are going to discuss in this particular unit? Device and gateways, first we will discuss on that. Then local and the wide area networks, we will see what is the role of network in IoT projects, and then we'll go for an data management. This is another one, a very good topic which will help. So how a data management can be done, means how you can manage a data in a hardware level, and how you manage a data in a cloud level, and how you can manage a data when you transfer to the mobile apps. So that's different stages of managing a data will be discussed in this particular thing. And business process and IoT, that is how a business process, again, once management everything is done, how a business process you are going to apply in that particular IoT projects. Now everything as a service, XaaS, so this we'll discuss how means everything as a service to the customer. Once business process, everything you will decide, then your product will go to the customer. Then what type of a service you want to give to a customer, and how means how your service will be very good there with the technologies and all, that we are going to discuss. Coming to last one, that is the knowledge management. So this is very much important. How will you manage? There is a difference between data management and knowledge management. Many times I have told you, knowledge is the one that I can say like this, it's a ready cake. And data management, I can say like this, it's the ingredients of a cake. So how will you manage to prepare a different cakes and all? That's a data management. What's a knowledge management? Ready cakes will be there. How you are going to represent a cake to the customer? So that we are going to study, for example, blackberry forest, black forest cake, something like that, different flavors of cake, strawberry cake, like that, different cakes will be there, and you are going to represent in a different manner that particular cake. So that is the knowledge management, which is a ready thing, and you are going to represent that directly to a customer. So that is called the knowledge management in depth we are going to discuss in this particular unit. And this is the one major unit which we are going to discuss, and I can say like this, it's a large unit which you can go to discuss the different things, and I can say heart of this entire IoT, this particular chapter or this particular unit. So don't miss almost all the lectures of this particular unit. And in exam also, more marks or more questions will be there from this particular unit only. Coming to the topics here, device and gateways. First, we'll start with the introduction. So what device and a gateways, we'll see first with the introduction, and later on we'll go discuss in depth what are devices and gateways. So there is a full spectrum of M2M and IoT devices. And to avoid a confusion, let's start with explaining what is referred to as a device here. So first word always will come here. What's a device? What I'm going to use in that? A device is a hardware unit that can sense aspects of its environment and or accurate, that is, perform tasks in its environment. Full stop there. What actually means it, the device, in our general terms, I can say like a device is the one I will keep in an environment, and that device should sense the surroundings in that particular environment, what I want. That is the one way. Or another way is, in an environment, it should do something. I will put one particular device, and that device will do an event in one particular environment. For example, you can take like this. I will put in a moisture level sensor. That moisture level sensor will go in depth of the root of a plant or a soil, and it will check the moisture level in that particular soil. So which will interact with the environment. It will sense the moisture level inside the soil but at the root. Next thing. So I will, based on a moisture level, I will run the motor pump. So how I will run a motor pump? Through my mobile, something like that. I run a motor pump. That is, when the pump is connected to the environmental product assist, that is a drip irrigation or a valve, it will be connected. So when I will make the things automated, my pump will become an actuator here. So it will perform its tasks in an environment. A device can be characterized as having several properties. including what a device you are going to use in general, full device I'm going to tell. A microcontroller, it will be of 8-bit or 16 or 32-bit, still you can have 64-bit also working memory and storage. So that microcontroller with that memory and working storage means that storage should also be there, power source. A power source should be there for that particular device, so that is a fixed, you can use a fixed or a battery or energy harvesting or a hybrid. It depends on your ways, how means chargeable battery you can use, fixed batteries you can use, or energy harvesting batteries means solar I will use and I will make a battery, means I will use that hybrid batteries I can use in my device. And in my device, I'm going to use sensors and actuators also. Means on board sensors, maybe within a board sensor is enough for me, or actuators is enough, or circuitry that allows them to conduct sampled, conditioned, and controlled. Means not only on a board, I need some place to place that particular sensors and actuators, and my device will be somewhere else. So for this, I need a circuitry, how I should connect that particular sensors and actuators later on, how I should operate that one, means how I can make connected to that, and how I can condition to that, and how I can control which is far place from my particular device, that is sensors and actuators. Minimum I can say, far place I can say like this. So you can ask me the question, sir, can a sensor connect with an wireless also? Yeah, some sensors you can make a wireless connection also, but how you're making a connection depends, means different types of sensors or different types of actuators. So with the wired connection also you can do, means how a different wire connections you are going to draw from there and how you are connecting to your GPIOs. So this plays a very much important roles when you are going with a real time experiments. Coming to the next, communication. So what? My device has to communicate. That part also is there. Why? Because after sensing any data, or after doing some event, means getting some information at all, I will process that particular information according to the need or a goal. Okay, now the processed information is there in my device and I want to send it to somewhere else. So my device should be a communication device also. Means it should communicate. So for that, cellular, wireless, or a wired, LAN, or WAN communication I can use. Depends. It depends which communication you are going to use. Either device-to-device communication within nearby you are doing. So wireless or a wired you can use. Cellular also, through mobile also you can communicate. Like that, different, sorry. Or you can have your own, this one means... So your own network setup can be arranged to communicate with the devices. So that's a one. Coming to next, operating system. This is a very important thing, operating system. So which operating system you are going to use? Either mind loop operating system, means a device which will be always connected to a basic concepts on mind loop, or event based, or real time, or full featured OS. So which one you are going to take into? For example, I will use a Raspberry Pi. Full featured OS will be there. Raspberry Pi is nothing but a small computer. The board in that memo operating system will be there when you connect that to a terminal, or I can say the display device. It will be like your Unix operating system where you can do your coding, everything, almost all everything you can execute. So that is like a full featured OS. Some things you can do Arduino, you know, boards and all. This will works on a real-time applications. Means I will burn the code into or upload the code into the board, and later on, according when the connections has been led based on an event, it will keep on working. So event-based, you can say both, that's an hybrid Arduino, which will have both event-based and real-time. And a main loop means always in a loop it should work, means Arduino will have that feature also, except a full-featured OS. So your Raspberry Pi is having all these features. That means you can work it as a system, You can make that as an event-driven based, or you can make that as a real-time based. So it's left, means you can take it in a different ways. That. Coming to the next applications. So simple sensor sampling or more advanced applications you can use. So what type of an application I want to use in that particular device? How that application will be connected to a customer or a user interface. What is this user interface? So, okay, my product is ready or my device is ready. How user interface I am going to represent? So, how I am displaying the menu or device to my customer. So either I'm using a buttons, other user-friendly things which will be there, maybe. So the film star will keep on telling you how UID things will be there, means user interface things will be there and all. So that is one major thing when we are representing. For example, assume I am representing to the end user with an app. So one app will be there with a mobile, you can see that app in that full of buttons. And the display, everything will be there. You can click on that button, so automatically my device will operate. For example, I can say the home automation is that the bulb switch and all, which we have seen in a blink, we have placed the buttons. And for a user, what I will tell, you have this APK, man, keep this APK, and I will fix the device in your house. But internet should be there in your house always. Wi-Fi is there, and tell yes. Tell me your Wi-Fi username and a password. I'll ask it. He will tell, yes, my username and password is so-and-so. I'll fix in that particular device. I'll keep that NodeMCU device in his house connected to one particular bulb or a fan to a relay module. I will tell, you have this APK with you. When you want to switch it off and on, you can do from wherever a place you want in the world, means in a far place through internet. I'll tell you, user knows only this much. What the user knows, the end user, when I open this particular home automation app, so a buttons will be there, means a bulb number one, hall bulb number one, or living room bulb number one, or bedroom bulb number one, bulb number two, bulb number three, something like that, or fan number one, fan number two, AC, everything is there. So just you will take that and you will switch it on and off. Means you will think like that. He knows only that menu will be open when he opens the app, and there a button will be there. If I click on that button, my bulb will be on and off in a house. So only this much he knows. But in turn, that way we should represent. It is an abstract level of representation. So like this, always each and every project should be represented to the end user. Now device management. Now the next thing is how you are managing this particular device. This is another one major thing, that is provisioning firmware and bootstrapping and monitoring. So how it will boot automatically and how we will make provisioning of that. As I told now in our project, Azure, the home automation project, provisioning, how we are going to do the things. The internet, through the internet, I'm going to provisioning the customer through an app about on and off buttons. He can do the, means he can operate. The firmware, so where actually we have to fix this particular model in a house. So how bootstrapping means how it should boot automatically according to the event, and a monitoring, how a monitoring thing should be done, either the bulb is on always, if no movement is there, the intimation should be given to the user, how you are going to do that things and all. So this is a monitoring. I left a fan and I have came as you, for example, I will tell you. For some particular moment, you will observe any motion is there in that particular area and all. You will see and you will tell if no one is moving in that particular time, for example, some 15 to 20 minutes of a time, then you will tell the particular fan is switched off. It comes to the user, where he is, assume he is there in his working place in electronic city, far from Alahanka. And then when once the notification will comes to him, he will open that and he will see, yes, the bulb or a fan is on. He wants to switch it off, he will switch it off. Now, what I told you previous and now what I'm telling you, so what it deviated, it's like this, we are making it different. So that is a device management. How you are managing your device and how you are monitoring your device, that will come in a different way. Execution environment. What is this execution environment? How you are going to execute your entire device? Application lifecycle management and application programming interface. These are the two things always we'll use. What is this application lifecycle management? The application lifecycle management will be like this, starting from a booting, giving an output. Either my product doing this, means from starting stage of booting stage, means switching on and off, means on stage, giving a required output, whether it's going through its life cycle, means sensing, accumulating, or doing a, means that executing, following a threshold values, everything it's doing or not, and finally it has to reach the goal. This is an application life cycle. And application programming interfaces, that is APIs. So with how my device has been connected to an internet, and what is a open APIs which I'm going to use, or a tokens which I've used to connect to that particular internet. Once it has been connected like that, in entire public internet, my device will have its own IP address and you can access that. Even in, from mobile, I can access, means everyone, means my device, we will be connected automatically, means with one means IP address. It should be known to others also. Next, for several reasons, one or more of these functions are often hosted on a gateway instead. Now you will get a confused, sir, you are telling everything about a device. What about a gateway? Well, see, according to me, in our language, if I want to tell you, both the gateway and the device, these devices, whatever will be there, will be mixed always. So gateway is nothing but the one which will mix your APIs, open APIs with that. It will connect to the internet or other side of any communication. So that's a gateway. So this is there in our devices also. Means your device will do your gateway work. This can be to save a battery power, usually. For example, by letting the gateway handle heavy functions such as WAN connectivity and application logic that requires a powerful processor. This also leads to reduce the cost because there are expensive components. If assume that, for example, I'll tell you Arduino is there. Arduino will do all the work, whatever is there, different sensors you can connect and different actuators you can connect and coding you can do, assume, just for a second. Okay, assume that Arduino, you know, will not be connected to any internet, or GSM you can't use, or Wi-Fi connectivity you can't use, for example. If I tell you like that, then you will tell something, how I will connect to internet, then I don't want this device. Right. So connecting here, connecting to sensors, connecting to actuators, getting information from them, or means passing information to actuators, processing that here, doing coding. Okay, everything is well and good there. But if we want to connect to other things, there should be a gateway. If you tell like this, for gateway, you should need another device. The cost will become more. Everything is there in one, and you will get just with a 450 rupees or 700 rupees if I tell. And it's a use. I have seen your projects almost all. No one has gone with the Raspberry Pi. If I ask you the question, why you are not gone with the Raspberry Pi, you tell, sir, cost is heavy, sir. So we can't bear that cost. Meanwhile, as a student, this is a one very important thing. What you told is correct. But what are the advantages when you are going to use a Raspberry Pi? Any of you did that? That is a sense, means that is the things which you have to do. For each and every, whatever projects you have did, you can do in Arduino, and you can do the things. What a flexibility will be there when you are doing with a Raspberry Pi. If you see that, more flexibility will be there in a Raspberry Pi. Means doing a coding, seeing everything, they just run the Python program automatically, it will runs. So it will become a very easy task when you are going to connect that if you put in loops. So that particular sense of working means connectivity, and everything, you can load your own storage is there and libraries there, like it will be a small computer which you are placing there. That much difference is there. Another reason to reduce the complexity by letting a central node, that is the gateway. What is the another reason what we are telling? Usually the complexity will become more. Assume that Wi-Fi, for example, for Arduino GSM model, you have to connect separately. Are you getting my point? So if you want that model, you have to connect, means you have to bring the board and you have to connect everything you have to do. And motor shifting, some motor things, anything you have to do, you have to make a separate connectivity. And even Wi-Fi, with the basic models of the Arduino boards will not have any Wi-Fi. So Wi-Fi model also, you have to connect separately and you have to install in that particular thing. This will make somewhat complexity, more complexities it will become. For example, I will tell you one thing, just for a second, telling you. USB. USB ports in Arduino. How many USB ports are there in Arduino? No USB ports are there. For example, come to the project of who is that? Amrita and somebody means what is that attendance system? If you come to that particular project, they are telling like that, sir, this particular biometric, whatever is there, means of finger thing, it's not taking, and we can't able to connect, power is not supplying and all. Connecting that type of devices with the wires to one thing, this will be the problem. For example, I'll tell you, assume I'll bring a USB connectivity of that biometric of a finger, and directly I will connect that USB cable to my Raspberry Pi board. Why? Because four USB pins are there, I'll connect directly. And just I will install the drive, what is there for needed for that. And then automatically it will start working. Even Amruta, you can listen to this. It will start automatically working. Once I will install a drive in that operating system of Raspbian, automatically it will work. So then there will be no problem of soldering that things or whatever display pins, whatever you are taking like that. That is the advantages what I'm telling between the different things in the market. So that's the first thing which will connect, and we'll put a driver and I will do a coding according to that fingerprint, and I will take a data out and I'll run it. That's it. So these things, even in a node MCU also, if you want to connect a USB, then at least USB female pin, you have to make adapt that to your board, and you have to do that's also other ways there. But complexity will increase somewhat. Complexity will increase. Next, device types. What are the different device types will be there? And which types we should use. We group device types into two categories. One is a basic and another one is advanced devices. What is a basic device? Devices that only provide the basic services of sensor reading, as I told you, and our accreditation tasks, and in some cases, limited support for user interaction. Just user can view the output on a LCD like that. LAN communication is supported via wired or wireless. Technology, does a gateway is needed to provide the WAN connection. Internet facility will not be there. No Bluetooth, no other things, means wireless connectivity things will be there, or even a wired WAN connectivity, only LAN connectivity will be there. So this is one part. Coming to next, advanced devices. In this case, the devices also host the application logic. The application logic will be there in that, and it can also host that to an WAN connections. So as now what we are using at all, everyone we are using advanced devices, Arduino Uno, and the Node MCU, what is there now, EPS 266, that someone Node MCU and the Raspberry Pi, everything. Now these ready kits are there, everything we can do all the thing. They may also feature a device management and can execution environment for hosting multiple applications. Gateway devices are most likely to fall into this categories. Now gateway devices, both characteristics will be there. Either in this side it can connect to the sensors and actuators, and here in this side they can connect to a WAN connection or a public internet through a different concepts or different connectivity types. You can see how a basic and advanced differences you can see here. So processor 8-bit PIC or 8-bit 8051 or 32-bit Cortex may be there, and it will work in kilobytes. Battery will be there, and 802.15.4 or 802.11 third wave communication things will be there in a basic main loop, or we can go to real time operating system. In advanced, you can see the 32-bit ARM, ARM 9 is there, or Intel Atom, which you can use. But now I can say quad also you are using. Raspberry Pi 4, it will work with Intel quad core processors. So it's a big thing. Now, according to the syllabus, maybe this configuration we are having. And megabytes, it will work. Not megabytes, now gigabytes, it will work. And then I'm having a Raspberry Pi 4 with me. That means 4 GB almost all built-in will be there. It means RAM, it will work with that. And the power will be a fixed one. 8 left to you, you can take 802.11. LTE means it will support to a connectivity to internet, GPRS or the 3G, whatever will be there. Linux, Java, Python, whatever you want, you can use that. So mixture of these things today, both things will be in a present boards. Then deployment scenarios for devices. How okay my device is ready? I know different sensors and actuators and how my device is going to work and all. Then how you are going to deploy your particular device in a real-time environment? Means I can say like this, how you are going to implement in real time. Always doing a project in a real time. Yesterday, you have shown me the different projects and all. So when these projects are prototypes, not a full projects, these prototype projects can work in a real environment. So deployment plays a very much important role. No one has deployed yesterday. I can say, for example, that Cradle, Turtledo means the experiment, a small Cradle which they have used, which they have shown. What about a real one? In a real one, which assume that a big Cradle, if you will take, how much power we need to drag that Cradle and to leave that Cradle? Means what's the weight of a baby, minimum weight and a maximum weight of a baby, how many months baby, what until how many months the Cradle can be used, and what will be the weight of a baby. So this much weight of a baby is there, how much force should we should apply to move that particular Cradle. So lot of things will come soon. When we come in a real time environment to deploy that particular project. So that deployment scenarios is very much important. So you can see now some examples here. Example deployment scenarios for basic devices includes home alarms. For example, you take a home alarm. I think Surya, I think. So such devices typically include motion detectors, magnetic sensors, and smoke detectors. A central unit takes a care of the application logic that calls a security and sound channel alarm if a sensor is activated when the alarm is off. The central unit also handles the WAN connection towards the alarm central. These systems are currently often based on proprietary radio protocols. So you can use your own frequencies there and proprietary radio calls you can use. And home alarms using different sensors, you can make this particular text. For example, in a Surya case and all, when they want to connect that to alarms, means they want to make alarm in a fire extinguisher and all, they can use their own proprietary radio protocols there. Yeah, it's a, I can say like this, fire rather 102 or 101 get phone body, that fire rather 101, it's a reserved one. 100 police station, it's a reserved one. 108 ambulance, it's a reserved one. So automatically normally it will go there, and it will connect. Means that radio frequency or the protocols will be fixed for that particular purpose only. So you can connect and you can send a message to, in that sense is coming to next. Smart meters. How smart meters will work? The meters are installed in the households and measure consumption of, for example, electricity or a gas, how much you have consumed. A concentrator gateway collects the data from the meters, performs aggregation, and periodically transmits the aggregated data to an application server over a cellular connection. What I told, an example of your DESCOM meter automations. This plays a very, very much important role. Why can't you connect your meter directly to the BESCOM? Why can't you make it as a prepaid thing, like your mobiles and all, or DTH connections and all, a card will be there in a meter, BESCOM meter, a card will be there, card will be inserted. Once a card will be inserted, that meter can be accessed from else other places also. So once this can be done, then how much you will pay the amount? They will utilize that amount prepaid. Once the amount is getting out, means utilization of power has been consumed, then automatically we will tell you, means pay the amount and you can have still the power. For example, assume for the 500 units, I will pay in beginning itself. Coming to 450 threshold units, it will give a warning, you have only 50 units is there and your power will be switched off automatically. See, these type of things in India, if it comes, really is good. Imagine. And then even a water meters, every all this type of meters, gas meters, whatever meters you're taking and you're making it like this automations, and automatically how much the labor work will be reduced in a BESCOM, you can think. The major thing is giving bills to a customer, following whether the customer has paid or not paid. If he doesn't pay, then they have to go and they have to disconnect that. Like this, lot of things is there in a present manual scenario. Once if you do like this, in your meter, if you pay, somebody who takes out a meter, assume they will give a direct connection, that fellows are more. Assume if somebody takes out that meter, once disconnected that meter, intimation will be given to the BESCOM person that so-and-so meter number has been disconnected from their house. Then they can come and they can survey, see that what's happened actually. So they can put a fine and all coming, going charges and all. So this type of the things will be there almost all in the smart cities, developed countries and all. Why we can't have that? So you can do a research on the UN 6M projects and all like this, if you are doing ticket, for example, in a BMTC buses, conductors will be there. No more conductors, they have to pay. Change problem will be the big, big issue. Then so if they will issue the cards or a daily passes, whatever is there, just scan it, move. My door will open, get inside. Like a metro, how why you can't do like that? So getting down at particular place, conductor will tell. Means you will have a device and you can scan there only, and ticket will generate. It will give you a ticket. So nothing in the work means change, cash carrying problems of a conductor. Lot of the problems should be reduced in that particular sense. So that's also one of the best thing where you can think in depth on this. Just I'm telling highlights. You can think in depth of this. You can Google it. How in smart cities or in New York, how electric power meters are working. If you give that, not on issues, give that. You know, in New York, how it is working, in Washington, how it is working, all developed cities. So, Barcelona, how it's working, even you can say Tokyo, how it's working, how they are managing the power meters, means household power meters. And now, if you give, you can say the difference between our system maintenance and their systems. Why can't we give a proposal, say that it's coming in a cost consumptions, and you can also deploy that, not to make a burden to a household person, that's good enough. For example, assume now whatever a meter is there, the meter cost is assume some 5,000 is there, and the new meter which will be there of some 8,000 and something in that, okay, that enough. So some 3,000 enhancement is not a big thing. So you have to think in that way also. That is also important. Building automation systems. So different automation systems you can build. Such devices include thermostats, fans, motion detectors, boilers, different. Your water purifiers, fridge, different things. So everything you can build automated systems which are controlled by local facilities but can also be remotely operated. Local facilities in a basic devices you can do. Advanced devices you can operate in a remotely also. So then onboard units in cars that perform a remote monitoring and configuration over a cellular connection. So this is also today cars, in now cars are speaking. You can see the advertisement of an MG, automatic parking of a car. One, he will tell MG park automatically, you will get down. I think you have seen that particular advertisement. In that, how the MG will park itself in the parking place, and it will tell good morning to a customer once he starts, and they will tell what, how much AC you want, everything I can tell in words to that car. Means car is speaking to me and I am speaking with the car. So that type of concepts, I want to speak with my machines in a house, or I want to speak with a machine and machine should interact to me. The next days will be like that, and the next generations or next lifestyle will be like that. I want to speak with my machine and machine should interact to me. Robots and autonomous vehicles such as unmanned aerial vehicles that can work both autonomously or by remote control using a cellular connection, especially in the military side. This plays a very, very much important role. Everyone are doing drones. Now today you can use the application of drones. How these drones and all is there. One drone will be there, it will fly and it will do the surveillance in all the upper air and all, it will take a photos, everything. I will tell you, the drone should come and down land automatically on a land and it should become a vehicle. Means it should move with some wheels like that or chain like that, it should move. And in the ground level also, it should make a survey. And suddenly the drone will fly on house when means air, the sea will come. It should fall down into that sea and it should become a boat. Really, I tell you. Means the drone will fall down on a water and it should become a the floatable thing, means to survive on it, or even beneath water also it can travel like a submarine. It should go down into the water and it can see whatever on beneath things are there. It can see, take a videos of underwater and all. Can we make this type of devices? Well, question tells, yes, you can make. And this is more advantageous, especially in the military applications. When you focus on, for example, open DRDO website, or you can open an ISRO website, or a naval board websites. If you own naval board research is there, so you can open that website and you see the proposal projects and the projects what others have did. These things you have to do always. So when you see these particular things there, what are the new projects that they are doing beneath water? Sorry, how the communication can be done? So lot of problems you will get. Lot of projects you can see, and you can decide yourself where I am now and what I can do and what is my level of coding now, and like that. where improvement is needed for me. For a student, especially now in a fifth semester, now you are exposing to a world. Another 6 months, you are exposing to a world of a companies or in a world of a software. So where I am competent, where I will fit in this particular position of a companies. So like that, if you build your career or resume, curriculum vitae, definitely will be in a very good position. Video cameras for remote monitoring over 3G and LTE, so through video we can do the surveillance. That is also a project of your friend doing, Gaurish, I think. So motion catching or a surveillance using surveillance cameras, motion detecting, something like that. So that type of a projects, oil well monitoring and collection of data points from remote devices, means been at the earth. So oil well monitoring, this is these things though, especially in the mining things, these more projects are there in auto, like automated devices. Why? Because going inside of that and checking what is the pressure and how much heat is there in that particular place, and humans can't go. So that is many accidents are there in a mining school, mining, and all. If you take the many accidents will be there when people are moving and all. So if you have a remote devices like this, send first the devices without any man, and we'll check everything. It's comfortable to dig, then we will send. And if it is not like that, oxygen is not at all there, assume kilometers to there, they will keep on again for a corner. So at one particular place, oxygen level will not be there. Maybe rocks are very loosely connected. Sometime it will fell down. So if you analyze these conditions and all without manned devices, if it goes in and it checks, good enough. So connected printers that can be upgraded and served remotely. As I told many times that a printer should print automatically, even in a far place data, it should collect and it should print. So these type of projects are well needed. Coming in next class, we'll discuss in depth on basic devices, how these devices will be there. We'll see the architecture of that also, and we'll discuss each and every component, what is there in that, and finally we'll go to the gateways. Now I'll end this particular class here. Any doubts is there, definitely you can ask me. Any doubts? Nidya Martha Adira. Any doubts? How is the lecture?
Nice.
Kelsa idiya at least. Others. See, how many examples I am keep on telling you and all. Don't neglect that. System ga nimge ivella ollolle projects neevu madidre ivella ollolle projects agutte. Nim luck, if it is luck is good. Bestcom project and all, assume that one, the two members seri martina ankoli that project with the different modules. If you give a proposal to Bestcom, nim adrushta chenagiddu, it will clicks. Assume you on your luck, it will clicks and they will tell, yeah, it's a very good project, can you do this, implement this. Definitely you will start up with the company, means it will become in a different way. The Ninja app, I can say frankly, means whatever a Ninja app is there of vegetable and resource. And now, in the basic things, last 6 years or 5 to 6 years, it has been developed by a set of 4 to 5 students. In that, 2 students are BMSC, MCA alumni students. They made a small company in one house and they started that Ninja corporation, means that app they have made. And believe or not, and it spread like anything, and a company came and purchased it for 32 crores. It depends, lucky about.
Oh my god.
Hello?
Oh my god, and sir.
Yeah, see, always the things will start with small things. Luck manushanige yavaga engli barutte, means how it will change your career. So we should do our work, hard work. If you are keep on doing in one particular projects and all like this, definitely one of the other day you will be clicked. And click aadre matte hinde nodidira mundene irthira. So these type of things are that your alumni friends, they are doing a horticultural project development. I think some Surya maatadra avr jothe. Surya
sir illa sir line sikkila sir ninge
maatadi naina neen maatadra
ha yes sir maatadde nannu
yena yenandru avru
like avrige in group bekante like single aagi work madidre swalpa kashta agutte ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ನಿಮ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಏನಾದ್ರೂ ಕೇಳಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು.
ಕೇಳಿ ಏನ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರಂತೆ ಅವರು, ಯಾವ ಪ್ರಾಜೆಕ್ಟ್
ಸರ್? ಲೈಕ್ ಇವಾಗ ಅವರು ಹಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಹೋಮ್ ಟು ಹೋಮ್ ಡೆಲಿವರಿ ತರ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಒಂದು ಆಪ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಯೂಸರ್ ಇಂಟರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೇಕು, ಲೈಕ್ ಇವಾಗ ಯಾರಿಗೂ ಏನು ಬರಕ್ ಓದಕ್ ಬರ್ದಲೆ ಇರೋರು ಅದನ್ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡೋ ತರ ಆಪ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೇಕು. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಅವರು ಪ್ಲಾನ್ಸ್ ನ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸೆಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರೈಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಸೆಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರೈಸ್, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಇಷ್ಟು ಸೆಲ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಇಷ್ಟು ದಿನಕ್ಕೆ ಅಂತ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಒಂದು ಡೇಟಾ ರೆಡಿ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕು. ಲೈಕ್ ಅವ್ರು ನೋಡಿದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ಬೇಕು ಇಷ್ಟ ಆಗಿದೆ.
ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಶಿಪ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಏನ್ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಏನಾದ್ರೂ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಅವರು?
ಅವರು ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಶಿಪ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಲೈಕ್ ಅದೇ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಶಿಪ್ ಸರ್ಟಿಫಿಕೇಟ್ ಕೊಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಅದರಿಂದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ನೀವು ಹೋಗೋ ಫರ್ದರ್ ಕಂಪನೀಸ್ಗೆ ಈಸಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಲೈಕ್ ನೀವು ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಮಾಡಿದೀರಾ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಈಸಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ನಿಮ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಇಷ್ಟ ಆಗಿದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ ಜೊತೆನೆ ನಿಮ್ಮನ್ನ ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋತೀವಿ ಅಂತಾನು ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು.
Yeah, they will give money also. ಮಿಕ್ಕಿದವರು ಯಾಕೆ ನೀವೆಲ್ಲ ಅಟ್ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಫೋನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ತಗೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಒಂದ್ ಟೀಮ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ನೀವ್ ಯಾಕೆ ವರ್ಕ್ ಮಾಡಬಾರ್ದು ಅಂತ ಪ್ರಾಜೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ? ಒಂದ್ ನಾಲ್ಕೈದು ಜನ ಸೇರ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಮಾಡಿ, ನಿಜವಾಗ್ಲೂ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್. ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಎ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಶಿಪ್ ಸರ್ಟಿಫಿಕೇಟ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ, ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಸಮ್ ಮನಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್, ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್? ನೋ, ಆಪ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಮಾಡಕ್ ಆಗಲ್ವಾ? ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು, ಕಂಡ್ರು ಮನ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಷ್ಟೇ. ನೀವು ನಾನು ನಮ್ಮ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಐ ನೋ ಮೈ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ದೇ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡೂ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್. ಬಟ್ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಏನಂದ್ರೆ ಮುಂದೆ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಇಡಕ್ಕೆನೆ ಬಾಧೆ, ಸೋಂಬೇರಿತನ. ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ರಿಮೂವ್ ದಟ್, ಯು ಆರ್ ಜೀನಿಯಸ್. ಮೀನ್ಸ್ IIT ಅವರು ನಿಮ್ ಮುಂದೆ ವೇಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತಾರೆ, ನೀವೇ ಹೆಚ್ಚೆ ಮುಂದೆ ಇಡ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಈಗ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಸೀನಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಹಾಗೆ ಇದ್ದಿತ್ತು ಫಿಫ್ತ್ ಸೆಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ, ಈಗ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದಾರೆ ಅವನ ಅಭಿ ಸಾಗರ್ ಸಂತೋಷ್ ಇವರೆಲ್ಲ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದಾರೆ? ಇವಾಗ ಕಂಪ್ನಿಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ಕೊಂಡು ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಕಂಪ್ನಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಪ್ರಾಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಹಿಡ್ದಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಥಿಂಕ್. ಅವಾಗ ಕಷ್ಟ ಬಿಡೋ ಬದಲು ವೈ ಕಾಂಟ್ ಯು ಡೂ ಫ್ರಮ್ ನೌ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್? ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೈ ಇಂಟೆನ್ಷನ್. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ರಿಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಟು ಯು. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ರಿಯಲಿ 4-5 ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ರೆಡಿ ಇನ್ ಎ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಟು ಡೂ ದಿಸ್, ರಿಯಲಿ ಗಿವ್ ಯುವರ್ ನೇಮ್ಸ್. ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಸಜೆಸ್ಟ್, ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಟೆಲ್ ಹಿಮ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೇಕ್ ದೀಸ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ವರ್ಕ್. And you should work for a real time, not for like academic projects. I'm telling very clearly, you should be like that always. Yenadru madidre full aagi maadi. Okay, are you getting?
Yes sir.
Maadi ond ashtu jana seri maadi. Surya naina jothe join aago.
Ha sir, maatadtene avr jothe.
ಮಾತಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಒಂದ್ ಅರ್ಚನ ಮಾಡಿ, ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಪ್ರಾಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅದು. ಇವನ್ ಬೇಕಿದ್ರೆ 6-7 ಅದನ್ನ ಅಡಾಪ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದು, ಏನೋ ಒಂದ್ ಮಾಡೋದಾಗತ್ತೆ. ಅವನೇ ಒಂದ್ ಕಂಪನಿ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಕಂಪನಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡಿರ್ದಂಗೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಶಿಪ್. ಮತ್ತೆ ನೀವ್ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಶಿಪ್ ಬೇರೆ ಹುಡ್ಬೇಕು, ಅದ್ ಬೇರೆ ಸಪರೇಟ್ ಇದೆ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ಯು ಕೀಪ್ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಮೈಂಡ್? ಸೊ 6-1 ಇಸ್ ಅ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಶಿಪ್ ಫಾರ್ 4 weeks ಆರ್ 5 weeks, ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಪ್ರಾಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದೇರ್. ಎರಡು ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಶಿಪ್ ಆದಂಗೆ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡುತ್ತಲ್ವಾ? ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಪ್ಲಾನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ.
ಓಕೆ ಸರ್.
ಸರಿ, ಆದಿತ್ಯ ಆದಿತ್ಯ ಅಟೆಂಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಬೇಗ ಬೇಗ. ಆದಿತ್ಯ ಇಲ್ಲ, ನಿದ್ದೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದೇನಾ?
ಅಜಯ್ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್ ಸಿಗ್ತಿಲ್ಲ.
ಅಜಯ್?
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್.
ಅಮಿತ್?
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್.
ಅಂತಿಮ? ಅಪೂರ್ವ?
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್.
ಅಶ್ವಿನಿ?
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್.
ಬಿಂದು?
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್.
ದಿವ್ಯೇಶ್? ಹೇ, ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ಟು ದಿವ್ಯೇಶ್? ಹಿ ಕೇಮ್ ಫಾರ್ ಪ್ರಾಜೆಕ್ಟ್, ನೌ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಥಿಯರಿ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್. ಏನಾಗಿದೆ ದಿವ್ಯೇಶ್ಗೆ? ಗೌರೀಶ್?
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್.
Gautami?
Present, sir.
Gunashekar?
Present, sir.
Harini? Harini? ಹರಣಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಪಕ್ಕಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿರ್ತಾಳ, ಆರಾಮಾಗಿ ಆನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಪಕ್ಕಕ್ಕೆ ಹಾಕ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಆರಾಮಾಗಿ ಮನೆ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು. ಏನೋ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ ಪಾಪ ಅಲ್ವಾ, ಅದು ಬೆಸ್ಟ್. ಅದು ಇಲ್ಲ ನಿದ್ದೆ ಮಾಡೋದು ಏನೋ ಒಂದು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೂರ್ಯ ನೈನಾ ನಿಜ್ಮಾ ಸಾರಿ ನಜ್ಮಾ ನಿಧಿ ಪ್ರದೀಪ್ ಪ್ರೀತಿ ಪ್ರೀತಿ
ಸರ್ ಶಿ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ವೆಲ್ ಸರ್.
ಓಕೆ ಅಮ್ಮ. ರಾಜೇಶ್ ಓಕೆ. ಸಹದೇವ್
ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್.
ಸಾಕೇತ್ ಸಾಕೇತ್ ಸಂತೋಷ್
ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್.
ಸೀಮಾ
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್.
ಸಿಂಚನಾ
ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್.
ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಫೂರ್ತಿ
ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್.
ಶಶಾಂಕ್
ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್.
ವರ್ಷಾ
ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್.
ಯಶಸ್ವಿನಿ
ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್.
ಅಮೃತಾ ಅಮೃತಾ
ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್.
ಅಮೃತ ನಾನು ಹೇಳಿದ್ ನೋಡ, ಯು ಎಸ್ ಬಿ ಕನೆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಇದ್ರೆ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಗತ್ತಂತೆ ನನ್ನ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ ಹೇಳ್ದ. ಸೊ ನಾವು ಎಷ್ಟು ಬಯೋಮೆಟ್ರಿಕ್ ನ ನಾವು ವೈರಲ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಕ್ ಹೋದ್ರು ಅದು ಪವರ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಬೇಕಂತೆ ಬಯೋಮೆಟ್ರಿಕ್. ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸ್ವಿಚಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್. ಸೊ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನೀನು ಸಬ್ ಆರ್ಡಿನೋ ಮಾಡೋಂಗಿದ್ರೆ ಸಪ್ರೇಟ್ ಮಾಡೆಲ್ ತರ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು. ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಎಸ್ ಬಿ ಕನೆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಸಪ್ರೇಟ್ ಮಾಡೆಲ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಾಲ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಮಾಡೋದು, ಈ ರೀತಿ ಏನಾದ್ರೂ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು. ಇಲ್ದಿದ್ರೆ ನೀನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಪ್ರಯೋಜನ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಇಟ್ ನೀಡ್ಸ್ ಎ ಮೋರ್ ಪವರ್. ಅನುಷಾ ಹಾ ಹೇಳಮ್ಮ, ಕಾಲ್ ಮಾಡು ಆಮೇಲೆ. ಅಮೃತ ಅನುಷಾ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್. ಅಪೂರ್ವ ಕೆ ಸಾಯಿ
ಸರ್.
ಚೇತನಾ ಚೇತನಾ ಕಾವ್ಯ
ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್.
ಮಧುಶ್ರೀ
ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್.
ಮನೀಶ್
ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್.
ಸರ್ಫರಾಜ್
ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್.
ಮುರುಗೇಶ
ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್.
ಮಣಿ
ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್.
ಪರೇಶ್ ಏ ಪರೇಶ್ ಇಲ್ವಾ ಅವನು. ಪೂಜಾ
ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್.
ಪ್ರಶಾಂತ್
ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್.
ಪ್ರತಿಮಾ
ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್.
ಪ್ರತೀಕ್ ಪ್ರತೀಕ್ ಸಾಧನಾ
ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್.
ವಿಶಾಂತ್
ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್.
ಶ್ರದ್ಧಾ
ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್.
ಶ್ರೀಧರ್
ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್.
ತನುಜ್
ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್.
ತೇಜಸ್ವಿನಿ ತೇಜಸ್ವಿನಿ ಹನಿ
ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್.
ಆಶೀಶ್ ಆಶೀಶ್ ವಿದ್ಯಾ
ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್.
ವಿಶಾಲ್ ವಿಶಾಲ್ ಓಕೆ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ವೆರಿ ಮಚ್. ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ರೆಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್.
ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್.
ಏ ಪ್ರತೀಕ್ ನೀನೇನೋ ಅಟೆಂಡ್